we are starting with chapter number 1 of standard 8, which is arrival of Europeans in India. As we have already studied in the previous standards, and we know well that India was considered as one of the rich and very much prosperous countries of the world in past. There was much demand of Indian commodities in the world market. Peoples from different corners of the world wanted to come to India and to have trade with them and to earn profit. Right? So from starting of the previous era, India was considered as one of the rich, prosperous country. In this chapter, we are going to learn about the arrival of Europeans in India. How the Europeans came to India, how they became our rulers. We all know well, in the history, we had 200 years of slavery from Britishers. Britishers became our rulers, and we had to suffer 200 years of slavery in their hands. So let's know that how they came to India, what was the reason they came to India, and so on. So moving further, earlier merchants from various countries came to India from northwest via land boundary. Since ages, people from the world coming to India for the trade via northwest land boundaries. Now, what do you mean by land boundaries? They were crossing the land boundaries and they were coming to India for trade. If we know well about the world map, we know well that Europe and Asia are the two continents which are connected via land boundary. So from Europe, via connecting the Arab countries, it was easier to come to India via northwest. So for years, European traders coming to India via land boundaries, by crossing the land routes, and they were coming to India. Okay, when they were crossing these land routes, even there were certain oceans of water too. So we can also say that they were coming by land water routes. Right? So for many years, they were coming to India via northwest. They were having trade with the Indian merchants. And they were going back to Europe, selling the Indian commodities there and earning profit. Everything was going smooth. But suddenly, the situation changed. The land route stopped. The route via which they were coming to India, that land route stopped. Now, what was the reason of that land route to stop? The reason is Turkish country, Constantinople. Constantinople is the name of the country, denied. Now, whenever they were coming via land route to India, they needed to cross Constantinople. But now, the Constantinople country denied. They said not to cross their boundaries and to go India. So, this is how the trade relations between India and Europe stopped. As the trade relations stopped, consequently, the demand of Indian commodities increased in the European markets. Europeans needed the commodities of India in great, great demand. Now, what all things were in demand. Indian spices, black pepper, muslin, silk, cotton cloth, this all, etc., this all were in the great demand in the European nations. Europeans wanted to reach to India anyhow by doing anything. Why they wanted to come? Because there was much demand of Indian commodities in European markets. Right? So, to take an advantage of this rising demand, European countries, different European countries started searching the new sea route. Now, they all have started. As the land route has stopped, the demand of the commodities has increased. So, different European countries had started searching for the new sea route to come to India. They wanted to reach to India, have the things, commodities from India, and to trade them in Europe. So the first person to have an initiative to try to get the new sea route to India was Christopher Columbus. He was the first person who tried out, who ventured to find out the new sea route to India. So Columbus, an Italian explorer. Now, what do you mean by an Italian explorer? Columbus was belonging to Italy, one of the countries of Europe, right? So he is known as an Italian explorer. Explorer is a person who finds out new things. Was one of the brave sailors who ventured. Ventured means who take an initiative to find the sea route to India. But do the Columbus was successful? No. The Columbus was not successful in finding the new sea route to India. Accidentally, he reached America. Right? Whatever sea route he took, he wanted to come to India. But accidentally, he reached to America. Right? As long as Christopher Columbus was alive, he was under the misconception. What is misconception? He believed that he was the person who found out but new sea route to India. But it wasn't correct. India wasn't found out yet. Right? So where did he reach? America. Right? So as long as he lived, he was under the misconception that he discovered India. But this misconception means a wrong belief was obviously incorrect. He was not able to reach India. Right? Even today also, the natives of America are called Red Indians, and the island of Caribbean where he reached accidentally, that island is known as West Indies. Right? Let's revise the topic again. Christopher Columbus was the first person who ventured to find out the new sea route to India. He came. He tried. But where did he reach? He reached America by mistake. And he thought that it is India. Right? Still the time he was alive, he thought that he found out or discovered India. But it wasn't correct. He did not come to India. He by mistake went to America. Where he gave the name, the peoples living there as Red Indians, and the island of Caribbean where he reached is known as West Indies. Right? So the first attempt to find out the new sea route to India was done by Christopher Columbus, but it wasn't successful. Right? Now the next effort, the next venture, the next initiative was done by Gama. Right? So the next time the person who found out or tried to find out the new sea route to India was Vasco da Gama. Vasco da Gama, a native of Portugal, discovered the sea route to India. What do you mean by the term native of Portugal? Now Vasco da Gama was belonging to Portuguese or Portugal. Portugal is one of the country of Europe again. And the person living in Portugal are known as Portuguese. Right? So Vasco da Gama, a native of Portugal, discovered the new sea route to India. So now he was successful to reach to India. Right? He encircled the Cape of Good Hope in South Africa. So he started from Portugal, he came to the continent of Africa at one of the destinations named as Cape of Good Hope in South Africa, and from there he reached the port of Calicut in India on 22nd of May 1498. To reach India, it took 4 years of time. Right? It was 4 years of time when he, with his troop, was sailing on the sea and ultimately came to the conclusion and found out a new sea route to India, and where he reached the first, the port of Calicut. Right? On 22nd May 1498. So in the year 1498, first ship of Europe landed into our country. Right? Now after coming to India, obviously they would require permission from the King of Calicut to have the trade. We know well that they basically came for trade. Right? So when they came for trade, the then ruling king, Zamorin. Now what do you mean by the then ruling king? The then means at that time. So in the year 1498, when they came to India, at that time, the port of Calicut was ruled by King Zamorin. Right? They asked, Vasco da Gama asked for the permission to trade with India from Zamorin. Even Zamorin gave the permission. The king, Zamorin, gave the permission to Vasco da Gama, a Portugal native, to carry out trade in India. And this is how the Portuguese trade started in India. Now the commodities which were much in demand in Portuguese or in the whole continent of Europe can be sent via New